Good morning. Welcome to Morning Grind. Christ, let us continually offer up to God the sacrifice of praise, that is the tribute of lips which acknowledge his name. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Let us pray. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you all worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. The Jubilate. O shout to the Lord and triumph all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Come into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his holy name. For the Lord is good. His loving mercy is forever. His faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. I invite us to reflect on our thoughts or deeds, the things that we have done and left undone, the things that we have abandoned, the things that we have been wrong in our doing and our actions toward God. Bring all before God as you ask him for his forgiveness. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Psalms appointed for today are Psalms 137 and 144.
Psalm 137. By the waters of Babylon, we sat down and wept when we remembered you, O Zion.
As for our harps, we hung them up on the trees in the midst of that land.
For those who led us away asked us for a song, and our oppressors called for mirth. Sing us one of the songs of Zion.
How shall we sing the Lord's song upon an alien soil?
If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget its skill.
Let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth if I do not remember you, if I do not set Jerusalem above my highest joy.
Remember the day of Jerusalem, O Lord, against the people of Edom, who said, down with it, even to the ground.
O daughter of Babylon, doomed to destruction, happy the one who pays you back for what you have done to us.
Happy shall he be who takes your little ones and dashes them against the rock.
Psalm 144. Blessed be the Lord my rock, who trains my hands to fight and fingers to battle.
My help and my fortress, my stronghold and my deliverer. My shield in whom I trust, who subdues the people under me.
O Lord, what are we that you should care for us? Mere mortals that you should think of us.
We are like a puff of wind, our days are like a passing shadow.
Bow your heavens, O Lord, and come down. Touch the mountains, and they shall smoke.
Hurl the lightning and scatter them. Shoot out your arrows and rout them.
Stretch out your hand from on high. Rescue me and deliver me from the great waters, from the hand of foreign peoples,
whose mouths speak deceitfully and whose right hand is raised in falsehood.
O God, I will sing to you a new song. I will play to you on a 10-stringed lyre.
You give victory to kings and have rescued David your servant.
Rescue me from the hurtful sword, and deliver me from the hands of foreign people,
whose mouths speak deceitfully, and whose right hand is raised in falsehood.
May our sons be like plants well nurtured from their youth, and our daughters like sculptured corners of a palace.
May our barns be filled to overflowing with all manner of crops. May the flocks in our pastures increase by thousands and tens of thousands. May our cattle be fat and sleek.
May there be no breaching of walls, no going into exile, no wailing in the public squares.
Happy are the people of whom this is so. Happy are the people whose God is the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, written in Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, beginning at chapter 12, verse 27, ending at chapter 13, verse 3. Now you are the body of Christ, and individually members of it. And God has appointed in the church first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then deeds of power, then gifts of healing, forms of assistance, forms of leadership, various kinds of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Do all work miracles? Do all possess gifts of healing? Do all speak in tongues? Do all interpret? But strive for the greater gifts, and I will show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
God's plan of salvation. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with all the spiritual blessings of heaven. God chose us in Christ before the world was made to be holy and blameless, and to live by his love in his presence. God planned through Jesus Christ to bring us to himself as his children, that we might praise the glory of his grace, his free gift to us in the Beloved. In Christ, we gain redemption. Through his blood, our sins are forgiven. How rich is the grace of God.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the Gospel according to Matthew, beginning at chapter 9, verse 35, ending at chapter 10, verse 4. Then Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them, because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." Then Jesus summoned his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits, to cast them out and to cure every disease and every sickness. These are the names of the 12 apostles. First, Simon, also known as Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew the tax collector, James, son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, the one who betrayed him. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
When the year changes and it gets closer to your birthday or maybe even Christmas, and when I say close, I mean something like 6 months away, you tend to drop hints about the gift that you want. You tend to be pointing out, okay, let me be honest, I do that to my husband. We're like, hey, you know, I want to get that, or I want to get this. And so we're nearing that time and I need to start telling him further, more, a little more, what type of gift I want. Paul is writing in his letter to the people of Corinth about spiritual gifts. And he is saying to them, using your spiritual gifts for the building up of the church. Not everyone has the same gift. And it may not be what you want, but it might be what is best for you and the building up of God's people. This is not a discussion for my husband. He will get me the gift I want. But I'm saying that Paul is pointing out the gifts, spiritual gifts. Some are teachers, some are apostles, some are prophets, meaning that there is a mix, there is a division, there is separation, and everybody is given what they can handle and what they need for the work of God. But further to that, he says to everybody now, pray for the greatest gift of all. The greatest gift of all. What do you think the greatest gift of all is? And it's something that we ought to consider, because we spend too much time looking at each other. How come he could do that? And how come she could do that? And I can't do that. That is very much pushing us into sin, because that's envy and that's jealousy. And that is actually ungratefulness, because God has given you your own set of gifts. God has given you your own prize. You know, James writes in his letter, brother of Jesus, he writes in his books, every good gift, and this is James chapter 1, verse 17, every good gift, good and perfect, comes from above. Coming down from the Father, every good and perfect gift. And so if God has given you something, it's perfect. It is perfect. And we need to appreciate that. And so, but he says to everybody, even though we all have different things, let's all pray for this one gift. What is that one gift? Jesus Christ. He says it's love, but God is love. He is love. John 3:16. God so loved the world, he prepared a gift for us by sending his son. Gave it to us because of his love for us. His son coming down to earth for us. And it's not just to die. Wasn't just for our sins, but he trained, teached. He, scripture tells us, he had compassion. He was there with the people, and when he saw the crowd, he had compassion on them. You know, this particular scripture, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, we know it very well because we use it for weddings and a whole host of other things, but we really never embody it or use it and try to understand it in our daily living. It says, love is kind, love is patient, love endures, love never ends. Jesus showed us love. Jesus guided us on what love looks like. Paul writes about it from his encounter and experience with Jesus. But in Jesus's life experiences portrayed in the gospel, we see what this gift looks like. And if we understand when we get gifts or when gifts are given, we have to receive it in order to have it. That's why we ought to be praying for that gift. Pray to receive it, because we block Jesus in. We block him with our attitudes. We block him with our poor choices. We block him with our decision not to go the extra mile, not to do the extra of getting to know him, praying, wanting to be closer to him. We block him. We don't receive him. We don't receive or have love. And this is why we have so much struggle in our church, in our homes, in our communities, because we lack love. We lack Jesus and we lack his attitude. Because if we had Jesus, our attitudes would be different. We would be kind. We would show love. We would show compassion. We would be patient. We would be forbearing. We bear it. Yeah. We would not respond in hurt. And even if we do, we would forgive, because love is forgiving. You know, even Jesus' calling of the disciples was for him to share himself with all of us. He shared himself with the 12. He spent day and night with them, teaching them, training them, and even giving them a mission to go out and share this same love that he is giving to them with others. Heal the sick, cast out demons, be there for others. How are you receiving God's gift of love? Do you believe in Jesus Christ? Do you believe in God? How is your relationship with the Holy Spirit? All gifts from God, all love. And so when Paul writes about this gift of love, because he says, without love, we are like a loud clanging cymbal. Meaning, and we all understand some sort of music in some sort of way. It means there's no rhythm or flow. There's no cohesion. It's just noise. It's an empty vessel. There is nothing that can connect or relate, because we lack love. And that is the breakdown in our society. Love for God, love for each other, and even love for ourselves. We lack it, and we need to start working on it. Love properly. As one of our young preachers said, love properly. We too long spend time chastising each other. We know always how to do things better. I'm saying, you know how to do it better, then do it. Stop looking for the other person to do it a certain way, or somebody to get up and do it. You do it. You do it. You lend a hand. Lend yourself. Jesus called the 12. They didn't have to go. They could have said, nah, look for somebody else. Just as you say, not me. I pass that. I don't have time for that. Because in their hearing of this Jesus, in their knowledge that they were gaining from his journey, they wanted to be near him. We too ought to strive to be near him and act in accordance with the way he wants us. I mean, he gave them something, and all of us something, that we never knew we needed. Love. The difference with them and us now is that we have history to teach us. We have knowledge before us. It is written for our edification and our growth. Again, the choice is ours. But if we do not choose love, we do not choose to accept God's gift of love, then we will lose it, and we will lose our way. So my brothers and sisters in Christ, let's love in its true form. Let us receive Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior and embody the things that he has taught us to be there for others, to offer help in healing the sick, in whatever form that might come in. Support one another. Have compassion. You know, I was thinking about the woman at the well and how people shun her. How people said, you know, you don't fraternize with people like that. But he was the one to do it. He was the one to do it. Go beyond. Break barriers and boundaries. Let others feel welcome. Jesus makes everyone feel welcome. This is the gift we ought to receive, for he has welcomed us. And we ought to share as he opens his arms for everyone. We ought to open our arms for everyone. Let love abound. Let love grow. Let love unite as we do our part in loving properly. Let us pray for the true gift that is Jesus Christ and ask God to remove all of the boundaries that we have put up that separate us from his love. Amen.
I need thee every hour, most gracious Lord. No tender voice like thine can peace afford. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. Almighty and everlasting God, you are always more ready to hear than we to pray, and to give more than we either desire or deserve. Pour upon us the abundance of your mercy, forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and giving us those good things for which we are not worthy to ask, except through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Eternal God and Father, by whose power we are created and by whose love we are redeemed, guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that we may give ourselves to your service and live this day in love for you and one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite us to offer our own petitions at this time. We pray the prayer attributed to St. Francis. Merciful God, to you we commend ourselves and all those who need your help and correction. Where there is hatred, give love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is sadness, joy. Where there is darkness, light. Grant that we may not seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving we receive, in pardoning we are pardoned, and it is in dying we are born to eternal life. The prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a wonderful weekend, everyone. God bless you. I need just a little more.